Hi everyone. So today I'm going to show you how to use draw.io for drawing network diagrams and of course layering them with various scenarios. So let me share my screen here. All right. So on my screen, you see that I have VS Code. And I have the extension draw.io integration extension. So this is the extension you would need. So once you have that extension installed, let's get started with our first diagram. So you go, I have created a folder called draw.io, and let's create a file called demo. And then as soon as we give the extension draw.io, you can see that it recognizes it. It gets lit up. And then let's get right into the file. So we could hide this Explorer, the VS Code Explorer, to get a little bit more real estate on the canvas here. But over here, you see quite a few things. So I'm going to familiarize you with the different portions of the screen as we go along. But to get you a quick overview, on the left-hand side, you have this shapes pane. And then here you have the formatting. And then you could bring up more windows by saying view. And then if you want to view layers, we can bring the layers here on the right hand side. And we can do view, and then we can say outline, and we can bring the outline here as well. For now, we'll stay focused on the shapes and the formatting. All right, so let's get started. Let's create a basic hub and spoke architecture in Azure. So I'll start off with a rectangle here. Let's close this layers and outline for now, and then we'll bring it up a little bit later. Notice how I have 100% here. You could change your size to anything. I usually start off with 100% on the canvas. So with this, you have your first rectangle, and then you can mimic or copy those rectangle. Notice these blue arrows. You could either use those blue arrows, or you could use these tiny X's with the green checkbox. And then when you drag and release, it clones the exact object that you start with. So let's clone and create a few spokes and maybe a few branches. So we'll create a few branches. So again, I hover over the green and then I let it go, and it clones the exact same object. So let's size this a little bit so that we can create the spokes here appropriately, size spokes, and then we can create a larger hub here. Let's create the hub a little bit bigger. And then, of course, the spokes at the bottom. I'm sorry, the branches at the bottom. So now let's give it a little bit of a color code. We'll make it just enough so we can punch in a few items like text and IPs. So with this, I wanted to show you a few other items. Is that if we select Control A and select all, you have the option to use the style as sketch. I personally like the style sketch. It gives you more whiteboard kind of look. And then you want to turn off this property called multiple strokes. So notice how you see multiple strokes. So you could disable that. And there it gives you that whiteboard style look. And then I like to change the connectors. So I'll select, I'm control clicking these connectors, and then I can change their ends to look something like this on both sides. So there I have a few connectors over here. And then notice how they're all connected. So if I move one, the connectors move as well. So let's give it a little color to these rectangles. And in the fill, you have the option to do the solid fill. So let's do solid fill for the top rectangles here. And then here we will do the yellow, and we'll do purple. So now let's add some text over here. So we'll call this spoke one, and then we'll give it an IP 10.1.0.0/16. So let's try to make the appropriate font, whatever font we want. I like this font, and then I'll just change it to size 15. So there we have our spoke one. And then we can control and then drag it to copy. And then again, select the item, control and drag, select the item, control and drop it here, and control and drop it here. All right, so we'll call this spoke two. And then 10.2, we'll call this hub. And let's keep it 10.0. And let's call this a branch. And we'll make it 10, let's say 100.0.0/16. Oops. And we'll call this headquarters HQ, and we'll call this 10.101.0.0/16. All right, so let's make sure all of these size match appropriately. We can make it bold if you like. And here, make it bold. And let me just make sure that the font here selected is the font that we've been using. Right, so that gives you, and you can make it bold. So that's the basic hub-spoke architecture. So let's introduce a few shapes in it. So to view the shapes panel, you can go to view, and the shapes are already in there. So you could do search shapes, or if you want to hide it, you could just view shapes, and then you can hide it. All right, so in that shape, let's go to Azure. I've already preloaded Azure. Let me show you how you could do that. So you go to networking, and then if you click Azure, you can see all of the Azure shapes, and that's what I have here. So let's go to networking, and we'll pick the virtual network gateway. So this is the virtual network gateway. Let me make it a little bit smaller. And in Azure, there is an important construct of gateway subnet that I want to introduce over here. So let's go back to the style here. And then if we make this, and we can make this sharp or rounded, doesn't matter. And then we can, so these black lines are showing you the different subnets that are carved up within the VNet, including the gateway subnet. So let's call this gateway subnet at the bottom. So control, and so we'll select this, and then we'll bring it here. We'll call it gateway subnet. And just making sure the font stays the same there, and we can make it bold here, and then we'll create another VPN gateway. And again, I'm selecting it and control and then drag it over there. All right, so those are the two Express Route gateways and the VPN gateway, and then we can differentiate them by bringing the Express Route icon over here. So imagine that we have an Express Route connectivity here, and we can call this site-to-site VPN. And this gateway, so this is our site-to-site connected branch. And then if you want, we can update this to say VPN gateway, and we can update this to say ExpressRoute gateway. So let's do that. So EXR gateway, and then we'll call this VPN gateway. All right. So with that, we have the basic hub and spoke architecture. Let's label this as hybrid cloud architecture, Azure hub and spoke design, and we'll bring it to the center. And then if you want to increase the font, just go up here and you can increase the font appropriately. Now let's create a few flows. And by flows, I mean IP connectivity. So to demonstrate that Spoke One can talk to this branch, we can create a flow. And the way to create the, if you hover over the shape, you can see the green and the blue crosses. And then when you hover over it, it shows you the green circle. So you take from one green circle to the other green circle, and then let's change it to look like a flow. So we change it to curved, then we make it dash line, and then we remove the sketch feature if you want. And then, of course, we can make them bidirectional arrows. In this case, we have bidirectional connectivity. And then you can increase the size of the dash line. And let's make this green to demonstrate that the green flow is a working flow, meaning you have IP connectivity between the spoke and the branch. And that's how you would demonstrate the green flow. And let's do some another flow from spoke to spoke. Again, you just hover over it. And then when the circle turns green, you go like this, and then by the virtue of this being curved, you can just use this mouse pointer to change the arrow or the shape that you want. And then, of course, if you want to make that a red flow, meaning that spoke cannot talk to spoke, that's how you would do it. And then let's do the same thing for VPN to ExpressRoute connectivity, and we'll make this red as well. So that's out of the box in a hub spoke architecture. We do not have transit between a VPN connected branch and a headquarter connected branch. Now let's demonstrate a few layers. So to do that, let me open up the layers window here. And then what we'll do is we'll create a couple of layers. So if I click the plus sign, it creates a few untitled layers. So let's name these layers. So we'll call this hub spoke. The second layer, we'll call it site to site branch. And the third layer, we'll call it HQ branch. And then the fourth layer, we'll call it flows. Now, how do we move these shapes to the appropriate layer? It's really easy. You select these shapes, and then you click on these dot, dot, dot here, and then move it to hub spoke. Then we'll select the branch, and we will move it to the site-to-site branch, and then we'll select these headquarters and we'll move it to the headquarter branch. And then you can individually select these flows and we'll move them to the flows layer. So let's see if the layers work now. So notice this little eye icon that I want to show you. These eyes demonstrate that the layer is on, and we can hide it and by clicking on the eye. So let's do that. So let's turn off the flows. we'll turn off the HQ, we'll turn off the site to site, and we'll turn off the hub spoke. There we have a layered hub and spoke architecture. So again, hub spoke design, and then we have a branch, then we have a headquarter, and then we have the flows. So let's say that later you think about adding something. So let's say that we add, let's go to the compute and add a VM. So we go to Azure Compute over here and we bring in a VM. So we'll just make it a little bit smaller so it fits in our spoke. And we introduce the VM here. And then we copy the VM here. And we want to ensure that these two VMs are in the right layer. So the way you would do this is you can select and move that VM into the hub and spoke. Otherwise, out of the box, you can see that it is in the last layer that we were on. So in other words, let's say that I turn off flows, it will remove that VM as well. Notice this VM goes away when I hide flows. But that's not what we want. So we want this VM to be in the spoke layer. And so we just select it and move it to the spoke. And now it will do the right thing and we can hide. All right. So let's have all of these. Let's have this hub spoke layer on. And I want to show you a really nice feature called Scratchpad. So with Scratchpad, you can select these objects that you have created, and you can just take the whole thing and put it in here. And in the future, if you want to create, let's say you have a blank canvas and you just want to get started with a hub spoke architecture, you just click on the Scratchpad and it will create the whole thing for you. It's pretty awesome. So going back over here, I just wanted to introduce, let's just toggle, let's light up everything. And I want to introduce one more feature that I love. I'm going to show you all of the top 10 features that are useful in network diagramming. So there's something called outline. And when you do outline, it allows you to navigate. So if you have a large diagram, it allows you to navigate between different portions of your diagram. That's what the outline window does. And of course, you can bring them to the side as and when you need it. And if you need more real estate, you just go and you click on outline and it will go away. Click on layers and then you can click on the shapes. And now you have a much cleaner canvas with more real estate everywhere. And then you can hide this formatting as well. Let's see. There is one more feature that I'd like to show, and that's called flow animation. So let's say you want to highlight this flow. You select it, and there is a feature called flow animation that animates the flow. So that's pretty awesome. I love that feature, especially for demonstrating flows. And the last thing that I want to show you is there is a lot that happens in this area here in the formatting. So let's say that you have an arrow. For example, let's say you have this arrow that you want to make it unidirectional. You could just select none. And so now there is only arrow on this side. And if you want to reverse the arrow, you can highlight this and then go to this arrange tab and then say reverse. And notice the direction of the arrow is reversed. In our case, of course, we want the arrow to be bidirectional. So we go to style and then we make the arrow bidirectional. With that, just one last thing, you can have multiple, of course, you can have multiple tabs over here. So if you you have a, so you can call this, let's say, single region. And then let's say in the future, if you add another tab, you call this multi-region. And when we are in this tab, like I showed you with the scratchpad feature over here. Oops, I'm not sure why the scratchpad is not showing up, but let's view. Oh yeah, we have to show the shapes and then view the scratchpad. So if you go to this multi-region and then let's say you want to add a multi-region design, you could just drag and drop that and then you can make this multi-region and build your scenario from there. All right, so with that, I'm going to stop the recording and then I'll see you in the next video. Thanks for watching.